stolen from morgue. No clue to mystery theft. Another strange chapter was written into the Black Widow mystery early yesterday afternoon. The woman, held by the police as a Black Widow, collapsed in her cell and was pronounced dead. It's quite a yarn. What do you think of it?
It's hard to say, but I'm not convinced the Black Widow's dead.
What do you mean?
Is it possible for a person to take a drug that would make him appear dead for any length of time? You know, no pulse or heart action?
Yes, there are a few rare cataleptic drugs that would do that. Why?
These pieces of paper came from a drinking cup I took from the Black Widow's cell. They were slipped to her by a Confederate.
Strange odor. That could contain a drug.
Exactly. If we could analyze that paper, we might confirm my suspicions.
What are we waiting for? This is it. Carbovinicol, a rare drug used in experimental medicine to induce a cataleptic state. Developed by Dr. Z.V. Jaffa in 1942.
That cinches it. The Black Widow's still alive. This is Dr. Jaffa. Do you know anything about him?
Yes. He was a brilliant organic chemist. During the war, he was convicted of illegal sale of hypnotic drug. While awaiting an appeal in the federal jail, he died suddenly of a heart attack.
Heart attack? Heart failure? Strange coincidence. It's just a hunch, but I'm going to check with the authorities on this Jaffa character. See you later.
Good luck.
All right, Sherlock. So you've got a lead to someone who might know something about a Dr. Joshua that Weston told you about.
The name is Jaffa.
That's what I said.
Well, anyway, he was the cellmate of a man named Fillmore Hagen, who now owns the Classic Bookshop.
Good afternoon. May I help you?
Are you Mr. Hagen?
Yes.
This is Miss Winters of the Clarion.
Well, how do you do?
How do you do?
I'm Stephen Colt.
The writer?
That's right.
Oh, I read many of your books, Mr. Colt.
And pretty good.
Thanks. Were you looking for something special?
Yes, some confidential information. I'm doing some investigating on a Dr. Jaffa. He was your roommate for a while. You remember he died of heart attack?
Yes, I remember. But there isn't much I can tell you. You see, I never saw him before or after my detention.
It's my belief that Dr. Jaffa is still alive, and I think I can prove it with your help.
My help?
It's very simple. All you have to do is put an ad in the personal column.
Oh, gladly. But saying what?
Take this down for him, Joyce. To ZVJ, amazing prison disclosure, secret of living death manuscript for sale. Wright Hagen, Classic Bookshop.
But I don't understand.
Merely a device that may smoke out Dr. Jaffa.
Oh, I see.
Put it in all the local papers and call me if an answer comes through.
Surely.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. Hagen calling Jaffa. Hagen calling Jaffa.
Hagen calling Jaffa. Jaffa speaking. Go ahead.
Steve Colt was just here.
Colt? What did he want?
He suspects you're alive. He wants me to put an ad in the papers to see whether you will bite.
Hagen, I want you to come over here at once.
Okay.
Sombra? That mug Colt has got to be rubbed out.
You put it so crudely.
But quite clearly, it's our lives or his. Steve Colt is the one person standing in the way of our getting the atomic rocket.
And like you said, without it, Hitomo can't work out his plans to become number one man of the world.
An astute observation, Warde. But before we can take action, everything must first be arranged with Hagen.
Afternoon, Cole.
Hello, Hagen.
Miss Winter.
Pretty quick answer.
Yes, I have it here at my desk. And only 2 days after I placed the ad.
Understands your offer and will be pleased to talk business with you. 34 Chestnut Lane, today at 3. ZBJ. That's Jaffa, all right.
Oh, it worked.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
I'll let you know how it comes out.
Fine.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. Hagen calling Jaffa. Hagen calling Jaffa.
Jaffa talking. Go ahead.
Colt and the girl are on their way.
Good work, Hagen. I'll tell Sombra.
Sorry to bother you, but Miss Winters picked up the wrong book.
Oh. Well, here it is.
This book might interest you.
Hagen calling Jaffa. Hagen calling Jaffa.
I don't understand. I...
down to headquarters.
Hey, wait for me. Hey, what made you suspect that guy?
Remember the first time I talked to him, he said he never saw Jaffa before or after he got out of jail?
So?
How could he see him after he got out if he supposedly died in jail?
Now, why didn't I think of that?
You'll get your chance. Right now, we've got a date at 34 Chestnut Lane.
Ready for the test.
Ring back.
It works. I'll set it now and warn you when Colt gets here.
Case the house first. You keep your bright eyes open back here. If it looks like there might be trouble, just blow the horn.
All right, but I don't like it. Good luck.
Warde calling. Come in. Come in.
Warde calling.
Go ahead.
Stand by. Colt's about to go in.
All right, mister, get out. And get him up.
It's Colt's girlfriend.
Everything's okay. Stand by.
Okay. He's in the house. You got here just in time to see your boyfriend blown all over the countryside.